we're jumping inside Google Photos new editor for the web. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and your Google Photos editor has been completely redesigned. And make sure to watch through the end because I have a very important announcement for you. Yes, you. First, when you click on a photo to edit it in Google Photos, you might notice a little blue icon asking you to try the new editor. When you click on that edit button, you'll now have your suggestions tab appear to you first. So what you have in your suggestions tab depends on the photo you are editing. Now, typically you're gonna have options like enhance, warm, and cool. But you might notice other options depending on whether or not you're a Google One subscriber or if you have a Pixel device. If so, you might have things like portrait, blur, sky, ColourPop, HDR, dynamic, and more. Again, these suggestions are going to change based on the photo you are trying to edit. So now let's head into the crop tab to check out what's different here. This is where you're gonna be able to adjust your aspect ratio a little more significantly than before. You now have a lot more options when it comes to your aspect ratio. So you can choose between free, original, and square, but then you also have 8 other options here, like 16:9, 4:3, 2:3, and so on. So you can select whatever ratio you want and even drag to adjust the photo further. And of course, you can adjust the rotation of the image simply by dragging the slider along the bottom of the image. Now, you may or may not notice a Tools tab in your Google Photos. This tab is available only for Pixel owners and Google One subscribers. So I'm going to skip it for now, but I will come back to it later. Instead, let's move on to this Adjust tab. You're now gonna have all of your sliders appear in one spot. So before this was according to grouping of, I think, light and color and pop and stuff like that. So it's all now in one spot and you can slide to adjust any of them right from here. Again, HDR is available to Google One users, but the rest should be the same regardless. Now, this last tab is the Filters tab. I think this one used to be the first tab in the Google Photos editor, but either way, regardless of your account type, you're gonna have 19 filter options to choose from here. So when you click on a filter, you'll get a little bar at the bottom where you can adjust it further. So depending on the filter, it can look like maybe you're adjusting the shadows or the strength of the filter. But now let's go back to that Tools tab for a second. Like I said, this is only available to Pixel owners and Google One users, but here you have other suggestions for edits based on the photo you're trying to edit. So really it's like how it works on mobile if you're on a Pixel, where some of these things will be automatically suggested to you, but others will remain in the Tools section. Things like portrait light, blur, and color focus. You may have other options, again, depending on the picture you're editing, but you get the idea here. By the way, if you are a regular viewer, first of all, thank you. Second of all, you might be wondering why this is such a short video this week. YouTube has been doing something funky in my analytics, and it is drastically affecting my ad revenue. I've been doing a lot of work behind the scenes to try to figure out what exactly is going on, and to say I haven't gotten a great answer and I've discovered this happening to a lot more YouTubers would be an understatement. So I wasn't even gonna post this week, to be honest, but I figured the least I could do for you, my loyal viewer, is to at least give you a look into the new Google Photos editor. With that said, I'm working on a Talk Technomy podcast episode where I'm covering everything that's happening with my YouTube ad revenue. So if you are interested in learning more about that, just let me know in the comments below and I will send you a link to that podcast episode as soon as it's live. Again, thank you so much for all of your support, whether you're new here or a returning subscriber. I really, really appreciate you. So that's a peek inside Google Photos' new editor for the web. Do you use Google Photos to edit your pics? Let me know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google goodness. Thanks for watching. See you next time.